Hello everyone, welcome back to Altium Academy. I'm your host, Zach Peterson, and today we are going back to basics and talking about solder mask openings on large pieces of copper like copper fills or pours. Now, I recently got a viewer question about this and we were asked to run over some of the options in Altium Designer for applying solder mask opening on large pieces of copper that are not pads. We're gonna jump into this right now in this video, so make sure to hop into your copy of Altium Designer and follow along. Let's get started. Before we get started, let's take a look at this viewer question. Makata Salahi writes, "Hello, sir. Thank you for the great videos on PCB design at Altium Academy. It's really helpful all the time. I have never found a solder mask opening option for a polygon pour, although solder mask opening option is available for a solid region and fill. If possible, please make a video on how to set solder mask opening for a polygon pour." Great question. There are several reasons you might need to open up the solder mask on a piece of copper pour. That's actually the most common instance where you will see the solder mask opened up on a PCB. So I'm going to show you the different options for how to do it in Altium Designer. So here I have one of the designs submitted for our design review series pulled up, and what I'm going to do is just apply some of these objects in the PCB layout, and we'll look at the various options for applying the solder mask opening on these copper pours. Now, if you're unfamiliar with all the different tools in Altium Designer, there are three different tools that you can use to draw out large copper pours, and then how you apply the solder mask opening on those pores really varies depending on the object that you use. So first, let's look at the two that were mentioned in the question, which are fills and regions. Now, the fill option is up here under the drawing tool section, and in the drawing tool section, you have options to place lines, place arcs, or you can draw out a rectangular solid fill. Now, this rectangular solid fill is by far the easiest to draw out. Here you can see I'm drawing it out on the bottom layer, and just a couple of clicks, I've drawn out this big rectangle. Now, by default, this rectangle is going to have a solder mask applied over it, so it will not be visible through the surface of the PCB. And of course, you can verify that by just pressing the 3 key, putting this into 3D, and then you see here on the back layer, you can see our rectangular area of copper, but of course, it's covered over in green, which means that, of course, we can't see it through the solder mask. Now, here, if I go back into 2D and I just select this, you can see here in the properties panel, we have a couple of different options here. The first option is a paste mask expansion. The second is a solder mask expansion. So in order to apply the solder mask expansion, we can use a design rule, and I'll show you how to set up the design rule in just a moment, or we can just apply a manual expansion here in the properties panel. Personally, I don't really see a reason to set up a design rule specifically for fills in order to apply a solder mask expansion. This is kind of a rare instance where you would need to do it. And if you did need to do it in some designs where it was pretty common, you can set up the rule, but personally, I think the easiest way to do it is to just select all your fills and then go here to the properties panel and apply the mask opening here directly. So to do it, I can just check this box. And by default, I'm gonna have a 0 millimeter expansion. 0 millimeter expansion means that the solder mask opening matches exactly this piece of copper that you see here in the window. Now, for example, I could apply, let's say, a 0.5 millimeter expansion. So that's a 20 mil expansion. And when I put this into 3D, you can see here that we have our piece of copper, it's visible through the solder mask, and then you can see here we have this big brown region around it. That brown region denotes our solder mask opening. Now, one thing that I can also do is apply a negative expansion. So a negative solder mask expansion is where the size or the opening of the solder mask is smaller than the piece of the copper. So to do that, I would just put a negative value in here. Let's just say negative 0.2, for example. So that's going to be an 8 mil negative solder mask expansion. Then when we look in 3D, very simple. You can see here that we have our copper opening. We can have the solder mask all around it. And then this light region of green here denotes our negative solder mask expansion. So the copper extends just underneath that solder mask a little bit. What's another way we can do this? Well, sometimes we want to have a solder mask opening, but it doesn't need to exactly match the shape of the copper. Now, in order to do that, we actually want to draw out the solder mask. So we can do that by just going to the bottom solder layer, And in this case, I would want to go to my view configuration, turn off my other layers so that we don't get any interference, and I can just draw out a fill directly on that bottom solder layer. You can see here, I'm drawing out this kind of long rectangle right here in the middle of my copper, and if I just put this into 3D, very clearly, you can see just that region of copper is open. Now, as you can see, the fill tool only draws out rectangular pieces of copper or solder mask opening. What if I want to have an arbitrary shape? Well, in order to do that, I need to use the solid region tool. Now, the solid region tool is also found up here in the drawing tools area. I can right-click on it, click solid region, and I can just draw out my arbitrary shape like this. So you can see it's a pretty weird kind of shape here, and eventually I just hit escape, and this is my arbitrarily shaped piece of copper. Now, if I go over to the properties panel for this piece of copper, I'm also going to see here that there is a solder mask expansion option. It works the exact same way as with fills. The only difference is that it's going to follow this arbitrary shape. So for example, if I click the solder mask opening button, you can see here I can also apply, let's say, a negative 0.25 millimeter expansion that is then going to apply this negative solder mask opening that you see here in 3D. And it exactly follows the contour of this shape around the PCB. You'll notice here that both of these have options for rules for solder mask opening. So how do we apply a rule for these objects for opening the solder mask? Well, what we need to do is go into Design and Rules and go down here to the solder mask expansion area. Here I can create a new rule. I can then use a custom query to then define exactly where this rule is going to apply. For example, we're going to apply it to fills. And we're going to have an expansion that's listed here, which is 0.102 millimeters. When I hit Apply and I go back into the PCB, you see it's going to run the design rule check very quickly, but then once I put this into 3D, you can see here that this has been applied to these two pieces of copper. Now here on the solid region, you can see that I can turn this off just by deselecting the rule option. If I just deselect this and go back into 3D, you can see now it's covered again. So very clear, very easy to use, and here under the rule option, you can see in the bottom solder layer where exactly that expansion is applied. It goes all the way around the edge of this fill. Now, so far we've looked at fills and solid regions, but what about polygons? So for a polygon, we need to then draw out an arbitrary shape here, and let's see some different ways we can apply that solder mask expansion. Now, when I have an arbitrary polygon like this, I can always draw out an arbitrary solder mask opening using either the fill tool or the solid region tool. So if I just go to the bottom solder layer, you can see here, I'm just drawing out this arbitrary opening. And when I hit escape and go into 3D, you can very clearly see we have this weird looking opening over top of this weird looking polygon, and we've drawn everything out just the way we want it. So whenever you have this kind of arbitrary opening that doesn't match the outline of your polygon, just draw it in using the fill tool. Next, what if I want to have an outline for my solder mask opening that exactly matches my polygon? Well, one thing that you can do with polygons is you can select this polygon and you can actually move this polygon into the bottom solder layer. So what I can do is copy this polygon. I'm going to use this via as the reference. I can move this down into the bottom solder layer. Next, I can go ahead and paste this exact same polygon back in that same spot, re-pour everything. And then when I put this in 3D, you can very clearly see I have an exact copy of that polygon in the bottom solder layer. It fully opens up that polygon with zero expansion. In my opinion, that's the fastest and easiest way to do it. And like I said earlier, this is kind of a specialty thing. You're not going to have to do this very often, so it doesn't really make sense to try and set up a design rule for this. Now, what if we want to try to do this with a design rule? Can we do it? First, let me delete this existing opening, and let's try and set up a design rule for this polygon. So if I go to Design and Rules in the solder mask opening area, what I can do is, of course, use the query and select Is Poly or Is Polygon. And here, if I just select this, I hit OK, and I re-pour everything, putting this into 3D. You can see in 3D that even though I have a solder mask expansion rule applied to polygons, you can see here that it doesn't actually open the solder mask. So what's a workaround for this? Well, one thing that you can do is you can use the convert tool. Anytime you want to convert a polygon to some other object, you may find the option you need here in the Convert menu. So what I would do is explode this polygon to free primitives. Just select the option, click on the polygon, click yes, and then you'll see here when you click on this polygon that it has now been converted to a region. Then you can use the rule option or you can use manual expansion, and that's going to apply the solder mask opening. Now let's select the manual option and apply a solder mask expansion. Let's suppose I want to apply a 8mm solder mask expansion around this piece of copper. I'm going to put in 0.2 millimeters, and you can see here it automatically fills in that solder mask opening. I think it's a bit unfortunate that the polygon tool does not include a solder mask opening option, but like I said, there's a very simple workaround. Just use the convert option from the tools menu. You'll find an option there to explode polygon to free primitives, select that polygon, and then apply the solder mask expansion as normal. Thank you very much for the nice question, Mukadis, and keep those questions coming. If you ask a great question, it might just end up in one of these videos. Make sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, leave your comments and questions in the comments section, and last but not least, don't forget to call your fabricator, folks.